Canada's greenest fashion event, so we're really proud to have that title. I mean, we've looked at everything from our power source. So we have Bullfrog Power, who provides clean, green energy. They power the event. We had no bottled water. Toronto tap water is perfectly safe, and it's ultimately the best choice. We had Green Beauty did our hair and makeup, and they did with no electricity. And no electricity. And then the products that they use for makeup were all organic. And we had an LED lit runway, which is the first ever in Canada. Sustainable fashion. When people ask me what that means and what it looks like, it's not so much what it looks like, because it's really about fashion. It's the story behind the garment. So sustainable fashion shouldn't look any different from what we think of when we think of fashion. But when you start questioning the story behind it, that's when you find out that it is sustainable. So tonight, you will not see burlap sacks and hippie frocks. You will be witnessing a truly stylish and fashionable show that we hope will inspire you.
Nice. Well, the whole theme was innovative, inspirational, and definitely forward. We're going to use all natural fabrics, so it all stems from nature. I think it's really important, and I kind of try to do that with my own collection as well, using all natural fabrics. I think we've done a lot to this world, and we need to give back, and we should reduce the amount of materials that are going into the landfills and that are not biodegradable. So I think using all natural fabrics is definitely a one step to help.
My name is Evan Bedell, and this is Fashion Takes Action. Okay, so cotton, conventional cotton, they use herbicides, they use pesticides in the growing of the fiber. Sustainable design, bamboo, you don't spray bamboo to grow it. You know, it doesn't get infested with bugs. So by using this fabric, you're cutting out those chemicals that are used in processing the cotton in the first place.
Well, we're always trying to do our part, right? I'm trying to do mine. So, I mean, it's an honor being asked to do this. So, but I'm also an activist too. I'm a member of Greenpeace, and I do what I can. The material I use are dye in mud. It's 100% silk, dye in mud. So making these dresses fun for me.
My name is Candice Batista, and I host a show on Rogers Television Cable 10 called A Greener Toronto, focusing on environmental stewardship within the city. I think eco-fashion is important, and I think it makes a huge statement. Events like this bring awareness to the fact, but they also let people know that you can wear something as fabulous like this dress and know that this is 100% sustainable. This is actually made from bamboo. This is Damsels in this dress, one of my favorite Toronto designers, and the good thing about this is that they are local. And of course, events like this want to bring us back to our local roots. And I think they do that quite well.
So my name is Jorge Midense, and as of a few days ago, I used to be a graphic designer but turned into a milliner extraordinaire. That's what I do. I really loved the headpieces. They were actually made from found twigs and bark, which I found to be great, great idea. And the designer, you know, found all these twigs and just worked with it, and it developed into these fantastic little pieces. And I'm always, you know, a rooter for headpieces, because you don't see that enough. The whole show was great, because not only was it sustainable, and sometimes, you know, eco fashion has that stigma attached to it. Burlap sack with, you know, water bottle dress. But no, it was stylish. And I bet you can tell half the people that it's reusable and material, and they wouldn't believe you. Well, since I was here, of course it is fierce. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't, that's for sure.
I'm Jamie.
I'm Jade.
I'm Jen.
And we started the group Design Aware. Yeah, it's just a sustainable, eco-friendly design group we started within the fashion department.
They're working on their next project. Fashion isn't going to go away, and people are only going to demand more. And there are options out there. There are, like, sustainable fabrics out there that you can use that are actually beautiful, but just nobody knows about it. It's like, it's a precious commodity to buy, like, organic cotton.
Yeah.
And it shouldn't be. It should be, yeah. Everybody wears clothes.
I think that it's cool that something that is normally seen as like fashion, this, you know, narcissistic, shallow, superficial industry, can actually turn around and do something positive. It's not just about having to buy new sustainable fabrics. It's about reusing, it's about reducing, and it's about, yeah, keeping things out of landfills.
What is it? One man's garbage is another man's treasure.
I find inspiration on things I find on the floor, and I collect things and I use them for my designs. Yeah, and necessity is the mother of all creativity, I think. It's like, what can I make with what I have? I work at Starbucks, and they have this fantastic ostrich feather duster, and I'll just show you what happened with it. So it just sits on your head like that. How does it look? Is it good? I can't see myself in the mirror. So actually, this was my roommate's couch. Was. So there's a big hole in his couch. He wasn't using it, so what better way to make a hat out of it? It's interesting because I have to work with the little that I have, but looking at my things, it doesn't show, you know? It's a fine line because you can have the most expensive fabrics. I just find scraps. Yeah, recycle everything. Everything. From the paints, to everything, the fabrics. I was recently exposed to this whole notion of sustainability and eco-friendly designs, and it's great. And I would love to further develop myself down that direction for sure. It just adds, I don't know, a level of integrity to your designs, you know? It's selfless, you know, to think of the environment, to think of the longevity of your design, to think of things like that.
My industry is called picking. And that's a good term because you literally have to pick through hundreds and hundreds of pounds of clothing and textiles to find one or two items a day that will work in my store. And I do that every day of the week.
I'm Jody Fremlin. I'm from greengirls.ca. And I am an online boutique featuring eco-friendly clothing and accessories. So we've got the flat bags from a designer in Nelson, BC. And she's using recycled bike inner tubes for the structure and repurposed vinyl for the rest of the bag. And needless to say, they're a very durable bag. And even though they're flat, there is quite a lot of room and a pocket inside as well. Really good for skiing, biking, etc. You know, sometimes people complain that it seems to be a higher price point than, you know, something you might find in a larger retail store. But I think what you're getting is a higher quality, and in the long run you're not spending as much. It doesn't need to be replaced as quickly.
So what I like to do is find the things that are really well made, the things that are timeless and last forever, and promote them as high fashion, because that's what it is to me. So this is my booth here today, and I've got like little kids stuff. I've got items like a friend of mine took a lining of a Burberry jacket, and the jacket was trashed, and it was so unfortunate. And she was like, I can make something like that. Actually, we got three pillows out of it. And so that's really exciting.
I think it's new, but I think it's here to stay. And I think what we're going to see is it's going to continue to grow. I think what we're seeing here today is just the cusp of what's to come.
I think trends are good for the reason that it shifts people's thinking. So while I do think it is a bit of a fad, I also think it's a positive one that should be promoted and exploited as much as possible so that people start thinking consciously about what they're buying, where it was made. I mean, I think, I would hope that it's here to stay, just like I hope, you know, recycling is, but it can take generations to actually change the way people think, right?
It just goes into the whole broader sense of the changing face of society and people's values changing, and you either have to keep up or you're gonna fail. And right now, fortunately, keeping up involves having a moral conscience.
It's like people want to do good things, you just have to give them the opportunity to do it.
I guess we can either like sit back and watch it happen around us and jump on the bandwagon, or we can be the people progressing society forward. We can be the bandwagon, yeah.